Toast-Nia. It's Nia. 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 What up, fam? How y'all doing? What's going on? Man, get out the way, bot. I'm trying to get my time. Get out the way. All right, yo. This is Brother High 10. I wish I could say live and direct, but this ain't my podcast. I'm not streaming right now. It's just us early in the morning. And I took a nap. Ended up staying sleeping just a little bit too long. Got up. Finished the work that I need to do. And today we're going to talk about purposeful suffering or conscious suffering rather than suffering for others, doing some suffering for ourselves to stay on purpose, because if there's no suffering, there's no purpose. Keep it in line with my new format. I have to start off with today's proverb, and well, at least the proverb we're going to cover for the week. The true home, say the knowledge holders, the true home is a place from which the sun breaks. So we're going to hit that. We're going to keep everything. We're going to try to line everything up. We're trying to perfect the system, right? We're trying to perfect it, right? So Nia, you know the day is Nia. Okay. Hopefully I remember to put that in because I'm tired. But if not, I want y'all to imagine a Nia. A yellow Nia fouling right in front of my face, all right? And, you know, y'all forgive me, I hope. But this morning we're here to do our toast. Even in my exhaustion or whatever, sickness or whatever, I should be able to get up and lift a glass for my ancestors, right? More than likely, there won't be a workout this morning. I'm going to try to clean up the kitchen and maybe you catch that. But don't, just because I got a little chink in my ritual ceremony type thing. You know, I'm making adjustments, so I expect you to make adjustments. You know what I'm saying? Because we got to hold each other accountable, right? Do your ritual, right? Do it to the best of your ability. I'm adding, you know, I'm adjusting, so, because I'm going to be up all day, running around, on the mic. So, of course, you know, we start the day with some water, get that system cleaned out, had that ash, I helped the eye shade move around a little bit. You get your glass yet? He's still drinking out of cups. Get you a glass. You grown. Get a glass. Cause we need to let the new ancestors know we're about to toast them. The little clink, let them know that they're about to eat with us. It's a beacon out to the universe. But now, we're getting our bodies ready, right? That water. Nothing better than water. I love ambrosia, but there's nothing better than water. Right? Nothing. Nothing. You can't enhance it. Nothing is better than pure water. Drink some water, family. I wanted to try this one. I just brought it up from the basement. See how. Let's see. This is the original. I ain't mixed nothing in. As you can see, it still has the settlement. Let me scoot it back so you can see what's going on a little bit. You see, look. So, I haven't, the ones I like to drink, I don't like, screening them. I want all of the nutrients. For those of you at home that support the journey, usually I strain it so I can get all this stuff out, because y'all like the clear drink and I could dig that. But I want mine dark and murky. I'm just being honest. You know what I'm saying? Because that way I know I'm getting everything. Now, those of you that want everything, y'all have to, when y'all talk to me and y'all say, hey, I'm going to support your journey. Hey, can I have some ambrosia? Hey, can I have some unfiltered ambrosia? Brother Hatim. See, and when you get the original, you'll see scoby starting to form, and you can have your own. You can make your own from the original. Now, don't try from the ginseng or the lemon eye, because those scobies, they're good, but they're not the same as the original, right? It's like you have other things involved in that, and I wouldn't advise you using those scobies. But from the original, unfiltered original, y'all probably didn't even hear that. Man, I want y'all to hear that. Let me see if I can build it up. This one is ready to be drunk. I shake it up so that I get the sediment floating around in it. I don't have to shake it up. Plus, I like the tss sound when I pop it. So now, as for those that don't know, the shape of the bottle, the amount of liquid in the bottle, all influences the taste. Right? This is why when you buy a bottle from me, I try to fill it all the way up to the top, because I don't want no air, very little air up there. You know what I'm saying? I want the carbon to build up, so that when you open it, you get a sis. And sometimes you might get a little, you know what I'm saying? I just, you know, because a lot of y'all need the carbon to go down so that you can burp. Because some of y'all having heartburn issues and stuff like that. Some of y'all got some bloating and you need to allow some gas to get out this and get down. Get it all out. Just hope your breath is fresh. All right. So, thanking you for joining us. I salute you. All right. I salute you. Bow to the greatness within you. All right. First, we toast the creator from which we all come. We ask that this energy that is all around us be visible in our life today. We toast and we say, Ashe, Ashe, right? From there, we move to our personal ancestors. Now, you can toast any ancestors you want, but I suggest you take this time in the morning to toast your personal ancestors. Remember your grandmothers and your grandfathers. Remember the gifts that you receive from people and friends and families that were not here. Send them energy, right? Send them energy so that they can send you energy, right? Remember all those that struggle so that you can be who you are today. We toast them and we say, Ashe. From there, we toast this present moment. And it is Nia. Man, Nia is a powerful principle. And today we're going to talk a little bit about purposeful suffering and conscious suffering. They're the same. But, you know, being conscious, we're talking about being conscious. We're talking about being awake, right? Being aware, right? And suffering, right? Because we talked about suffering a little bit last week. So we toast this moment. We say, Ashe. From there, we toast our children, our children's children, on to infinity. We're going to toast our children of the day, because it's a struggle, and some of us got children in the home, and sometimes we got to remember that we're not just talking to our children, we're talking to some of our ancestors that have returned. So in some of our impatience, and I'm talking to me because I'm going to be looking at this real soon, and in talking to our children, let's remember that we are talking to our ancestors, right? So the traits that they are exhibiting, right, are a direct result of your ancestral heritage. I know some of y'all don't want to admit that. Y'all don't want to embrace that. But remember, when you're dealing with your children, deal with them in a way where you're teaching lessons. All right, these are your ancestors. You need to help them remember why they are here today. Why did they choose this time in history to come? And you need to get them to be able to start thinking about this so that they can let you know why they chose you to come through. So we toast our children, our children's children, onto infinity, because we pour for them, because we want them to be able to pour for us, and we say, Ashe. From there, we're done. So we say, Ashe, Ashe, Ashe. Click a sign, bring them every time. Cheers. Good God, girl. Nice and tart. Good God. I got another batch down the basement. Can't wait to sample it because I'm going to bust that one open about 6 o'clock tomorrow night. So if you anywhere around, right, and you know that it's Nia, you could, the password is Nia. Knock on the door. You say, Nia, I know you want to drink some ambrosia with me. You can have, I got some glasses for you. You can have a sip with me. I ain't going to give you a whole, I'm going to give you a glass. You know what I'm saying? We could drink and be merry, right? So I'm saying great day to you. I don't know how the video is going to go. Your guess is good. I'm about to go to sleep. I know that. You hear the train outside. I'm about to go to sleep. I got about 2 hours of sleep that I'm able to get right now, and I'm going to get every last sip of it, right? So y'all, saying peace. I know I'm supposed to be doing the toast when I get up, right? But nah, I've been up working. Purposeful suffering. Conscious suffering. But hey, if you want to be great, you got to do it, right? I work out in the evening, man. I'll take that for y'all. That warm, refreshing drink. This is Brother Hot Tim. I'm 49 and fine. I will see you tomorrow.
This is Cleveland, and you're listening to Gye-Nyame Journey Radio.
Great Nia family. Now, I don't know how this video is going to turn out, because I am officially in Nia, and I've been working, and of course today is about purpose. But what I want to discuss, because I'm sitting up here working on something that I love now, it's called purposeful suffering, or conscious suffering. Now, I'm going on the theme of the proverb from, hold on. Yeah, this is real time, y'all. It's early in the morning. To do these videos, well, I'll get into all that in a second. This is what I'm talking about. Purposeful suffering. Those that follow the show, I have two shows on Spreaker as well as on YouTube. You can follow the, you probably on the YouTube channel now, or listening to me on Spreaker, because you know how it works. Or maybe you don't know how it works, it don't matter. But in one form or fashion, you listening to me at this point in time. And I'm following the themes now for now on for the either from Folk Tales for Grown Folks or Tribal Quotes, okay? And one of the themes. Let me see if I can turn this light up. Excuse me. That ain't working. Alright. It's too much light coming off the side, so I'm gonna do it like this. Did that work? Nope. Alright. I'm still experimenting with lights and stuff, fam. You know. I know I'm dark. But I like dark furniture and, you know, and all that stuff, so I don't like a lot of that light stuff. But anyway. Purposeful suffering. Conscious suffering. I'm going along with the theme of dealing with either a folk tale that we discussed in last week's show or a quote. So the quote we're working with, because the folk tale didn't really superly inspire me. I mean, they always inspire me, but this one ain't really do nothing for me. The one that we're going to do today, it says... Hold on. True home is the place from which the sun breaks. Now, it's funny that this one lines up with the one from last week, as I discussed her in Ujima. We're moving it to Nia, so now we got to focus and hone the proverb in on purpose. Also, hone it in on so I don't have to think. Got my cheat sheet. Balance and rhythm. Alright? So, balance is the Maori principle. Rhythm is the Hermetic law. All these line up on today. So, we have to fight it. Ooh. And I'm talking about purposeful suffering, and you see me doing something right there. I'm yawning. I'm getting to the point. Just bear with your brother for a second. You know, just as they say, tarry with your brother for a moment, please. So sitting up early in the morning doing some stuff. And the proverb is, true home is the place from which the sun breaks. Last week's proverb read like this: awake out of thy suffering, O thou who liest prostrate. Awake thou. Thy head is in the horizon. Then we get to this week and it says, true home is the place from which the sun breaks. So now last week we dealt with a corpse or a dead person or a zombie or a sleepwalker lying prostrate, being told to awaken and arise, right? Being told to awaken and arise. It says, thy head is an horizon. Right, which, you know, you can't reach the horizon. Your head is in infinity. Your head is in infinity. Then we have the one we're talking to. True home is the place from which the sun breaks, which is another place that you can't find. It's a mystery. And I talked about embracing one of the things that we're missing in our community when I talked about resources for Ujima. Was we're missing, or we're not using the resource of mystery, right? This proverb is a mystery, and it's talking about from which the place from which the sun breaks is your home. Your home is beyond your comprehension. Your home is in a realm that you can't see, or that you can't achieve, or you can't find in this material being, right? So a lot of us, we're seeking purpose, right? We're seeking purpose, but we first haven't explored our true home, right? Many of us are being held down because we actually believe that this is our abode. This place that you see me in right now, this is not your home. This is not my home. This is a temporary rest stop. As I keep telling y'all, we're generational people. We come back over and over again my choice, right? And in us realizing that our home is that place from which, the place from which the sun breaks, this impossible place to find. And we contemplate that. We understand that we're bigger than many of the circumstances that are holding us hostage. So now let's bring it to purposeful suffering, right? Because in the last week's piece, we talked about awakening from thy suffering, right? That suffering that we talked about last week was suffering that we allow the world to perpetrate on us because we lie prostrate. We accept it. What I'm talking about is purposeful suffering, conscious suffering. And this is the type of suffering where if you have something you desire, right? If you have something that you want, if you have a place that you say you want to go, if you have a thing that you say you want to do, you have to be willing to lay it on the line. Lay it on the line. You call us to share, right? You got to be willing to lay it on the line. Right now, I'm fighting sleep because I have to get something ready for my kids. Right now, I'm doing a video because I got to get something ready for you. Right? Purposeful suffering. I'm a sleep dude, y'all. I struggle every day driving home trying to fight sleep. I'm struggling. I'm purposefully suffering, right? When I went to the Sundance, my Native American brothers and sisters, I saw purposeful suffering, right? Some of you out there are up early in the morning right now, possibly watching my video, purposely suffering. It's something that you're reaching for, something that you're striving for, right? Suffering is bad when it's inflicted upon you and you accept it. But on the other end, suffering is good when we are striving and we're doing it. Because there's no thing that you could reach, nothing you could reach without some form of suffering, y'all. You know what I'm saying? Get out of looking for shortcuts. If you could find, I'm not again, but a lot of y'all want to just jump from A to Z, not realizing that you got to struggle through B, C, D, E, and F, G, H, I, J, and K, and L, and M, and N, and O, and P, and damn, Q, R, S, and T, U, V, W, X, and then Y, then Z. Right? Some of y'all just want to go to Z. Right? Understand that it's a process. And in that process, going to come some suffering. And the suffering that you inflict on you is different than the suffering that others inflict on you. Right now, I'm consciously suffering. I'm purposefully suffering so that I can make sure that I'm able to deliver what people are looking for. So I'm able to deliver something to you. So for all I know, this might be the only piece that you get because I'm looking at the clock. And I'm going to be on my feet all day tomorrow. Tomorrow is a very exciting day for my kids at school. It's going to be a very long day. But I'm willing to suffer it. Because I'm aware and I'm conscious and I understand that the one thing that I might say on that mic might change somebody's life, or the one video that I cut might change somebody's life, or the one picture that I show might change somebody's life, or the one song that I select might change somebody's life. So I'm willing to suffer for that. See, when we become individuals on a journey, when we become Gye-Nyame, fear none but God, unless God, omnipotence of God, right? We got to be clear about what we're suffering about. When you become a warrior, you got to be clear what you're suffering about. Are you standing for your culture?
Are you willing to suffer for your culture? Are you willing to suffer for your people? Are you willing to suffer for your success? Are you willing to suffer for your dreams? Are you willing to suffer for your children? And inflict that on yourself and not allow others to inflict their useless suffering. See, because you got conscious suffering and then you got useless suffering. Where you lie prostrate to something and suffer for no reason at all. Oh, they paid you a little bit of money for your time. Come on now. So, you know, this is Brother High Tim. I'm saying to you, have a great Nia, and I will see you for the toast. I might just do the toast right now because, man. All right? But I'm going to get up early and do the toast and then get up out of here. All right? So, yo, what I'm saying is, have a great Nia. I will see you on Kaumba. Alright? For those who understand what I'm talking about, this is Dengu's Asaba Challenge. Calendars are coming. I seen my brothers. Gye-Nyame got something for y'all now. Those that want to take your life to the next level, we are about to drop it, yo. Listen, it's coming. This is Brother High Tim. I'm saying peace because my alarm about to go off and it will erase all of this. So I'm sorry for the rough hair. I'm sorry for having on what I had on yesterday. But I've been up since yesterday, right? Purposefully suffering, fighting sleep, trying to make sure my kids get home early because I'm getting up. I'm doing this for you. I do these tapes for you. Well, not just for you, for myself too, because I like getting my ideas out. I want to say thank you for tuning in. Sorry for the darkness. I'm still working on the light thing. Y'all know that, right? I wonder what would happen if I turned this light off. Hold on. Y'all just bear with me. Purposefully suffer for me, all right? Because you can turn it off. You ain't got the light prostrate and take it. See if that would work a little bit better. Nah, not really. All right, so this is Brother High Tim, and I am out.
Thank you for watching the video. I want you to subscribe. Click the bird right there, the fiery bird. And I also have a special video just for you, right there. And for those that want more information about Gye-Nyame Journey, go to our site. It should be right about there.